Is this the recipe for a perfect breakfast sandwich or a disaster? And you could ask, like, what can go wrong? Well, the thing is, I've tried it a couple times, and each time it would bump up my blood glucose by 40 points. Now, before we get too far, why do we even care about the blood sugar? Well, I'm following multiple longevity specialists, Peter Attia, David Sinclair, Rhonda Patrick, Walter Longa. They have their own differences, which I'm going to cover in a separate video, but there are a few things they agree on, and one of them is that we should have very tight blood sugar control.
Lower average blood glucose is better. The more you can minimize glucose variability, the better.
So, I know this video is not very glamorous, but if you watch it till the end, I promise you won't be sorry. So, what I have here is old-fashioned sourdough spelt bread, smoked wild salmon, medium-sized ripe organic avocado, and I created the whole list of things to try. And that's what we're going to do. I have 7 days left on my blood glucose monitor before it runs out, and I have 7 attempts to make it better. So today on the list is apple cider vinegar, darling of the internet. If you Google enough, it can heal almost anything. We're just going to try 2 tablespoons and a glass of water 5 minutes before, and we'll see if it does anything good or not. So what else I do have here? I have moringa and allulose, berberine, adding more protein, different bread, going for a walk, and combining everything we can on the last day, and we'll see how low we can actually get. And as I said, first on the list, apple cider vinegar. Well, at least it tastes pretty nice. Also, they say it stimulates digestion. So, not bad, not bad. So 1/4 of this should be about 2 ounces. And what do we have here? 101. Well, that's pretty much average for me. So let's dig in. I like this experiment. If everything fails, at least I'm going to have 14 excellent breakfast sandwiches. I'm going to finish this, and I'll see you in 45 minutes. Alright, we have 45 minutes in. Ramping up, ramping up. We'll see how high we'll get. Okay. It's time to figure it out. Apple cider vinegar. Okay. Well, if anything else, it made things worse. Oh my. I don't know what's going on, but it's definitely had an effect. It's just not the effect I was hoping for. Wow. This is huge. Okay, I guess no more apple cider vinegar for me. Okay, for the day 2, we're going to jump the list and go straight to the walk. Today we start with 105, and same stuff, same sandwich, same avocado, same salmon. Different but improved me. I'm just hoping for some positive results after that apple cider fiasco. Cheers. Here you go. I think we are flatlining. So the peak was at 135, which is so much better than apple cider vinegar. I guess it's working. Oh, today I have realized that I'm running out of days on my sensor. So I'm going to combine 2 treatments. Moringa powder and allulose. They're both known for their glucose lowering properties. I'm going to make myself a moringa tea. Just a tablespoon moringa powder. It smells like a matcha tea actually. And let's add 1 tablespoon of allulose. It's not as sweet as sugar, but in a way it is a healthy sugar because it lowers the blood glucose. Let's reduce that sweetness with a little bit of lemon juice. Yeah, perfect. I do not know if it needs any time to start working. So for the sake of experiment, I'm just going to have my green tea and avocado sandwich. We're starting. I'm not starting. Wakey wakey. And just fucking great. Well, I guess I'm going to get some tea. Alright. That gave me a little scare. So we start here. See you in an hour. Magic. Anyway, I think I've missed the spike this time. 121, but it's already going down. The highest I've been at is 130 5 minutes ago. So it was 27 points. Not ideal, but actually pretty good. Maybe in the separate video I'll try to analyze which works better, allulose or moringa. Stay tuned for that. Another day, another test. And today we're going to experiment with berberine, also known as baby metformin. It has a lot of health benefits, but one of them is lowering blood sugar or keep it in control. So I got myself a fresh pack. And the dosage here is 2 capsules, but for the good measure, I'm going to take 3. And as far as I know, it has half-life of about 2 hours. So I'm going to take the capsules and then I'm going to prepare my sandwich. So they should sort of peak concentration in the blood should align with the peak response from the sandwich. That's, by the way, how the frozen bread looks like. I need to break it apart. Here we go. All right, let's see what my blood sugar is doing today. Around 100, I hope. 95. Okay, even better. Cheers. See you in an hour. It's only been 45 minutes, but my body didn't like that berberine all. Tomorrow we're going to try probably extra protein. See you then. Today is rainy and cloudy and we're going to try a protein buffer in the form of 2 eggs. Ta-da! We have our own chickens, so it's kind of convenient. Which lay about 4 to 5 eggs a day. So, I'm a big egg fan. Totally forgot. Kinda got carried away. Check the sugar. Should be around 100 as usual. What is that? Yeah, 105. And by the way, that machine makes perfect eggs. I'll have a link below. Check. Alright. It's time to dig into the toast, and I'll see you in an hour. Right, it has been 1 hour, and I'm picking 128, 23 points, almost as good as walking, or maybe even better. So as a final test, I think I'm going to try eating protein and going for a walk, and maybe taking an allulose drink, and we'll see what happens then. Small change of plans. I got extra questions about apple cider vinegar from the subscribers, so I decided to use this day to actually retest my reaction. If I'm going to get extra blood sugar or if it's going to stay the same. It actually would be interesting to see. I'm going to do the same 2 tablespoons from the same bottle. It tastes pretty good, like a lemonade. Maybe a drop of monk fruit. Let's see where we start. 105. Yeah, pretty accurate. But that's what I usually have around this time of the day. So, it wasn't really liking us. They say that apple cider vinegar increases acidity. Maybe that has something to do with how quickly this gets absorbed. Maybe it was a bad day. Alright, we'll know pretty soon. Yeah, looks like apple cider vinegar is really not happy with me. So take it as you will. Alright, today is the day. I'm going to combine protein, allulose, going for a walk, like all the best things, and keeping the fingers crossed. Okay, we start here. 108, well, the usual kind of range. Let's start with the eggs. And I'm going to mix myself a little bit of green tea with moringa. This time I'm going to do half tablespoon of moringa. 1 tablespoon is a little bit too much, but half, just the right amount. And 1 tablespoon of allulose. Cheers. And if you have any good ideas what we should test next, yeah, you know what to do. All right, I'm going to finish this, go out for a walk, and we'll see how it works.
Well, it's a little chilly, but it might be a good thing, as I have to move faster. I'm not running, but it's still better for blood glucose control to be like near that zone too, I think. Well, anyway, walking is much better than not walking, so that's what we should do.
I just checked, I mean, it's hard. My phone is taken, so I cannot really measure and show you in the real time, but my glucose is at 116, which is so far so freaking good. I'm going to recheck in 15 minutes and knock, knock, knock. Hopefully it will stay there. All right, got lower. So let's get to my office and we'll discuss the results and what does it mean for you. Whew, that was quite a ride. Time to pull this baby out and hopefully you have learned a thing or two. I know I did. But if you actually want to implement some changes, there is a mental hack right from this book. Write down in the comments a thing or two you want to change, share this video with friends, and it should create extra mental connections in your brain and create positive pressure and circle between all of us, which is just win-win.
Okay, let's do it.
And if you want to learn more about this gadget, which I think everyone should, here's a video right for you. Make sure to watch it and stay on the Longevity Talk. See you in the next video.